Well, it's that time of year again. Walk into any Walmart at all immediately after Halloween, or any retail store at all for that matter, and there's a definitive reminder that the holiday season is upon us. And they make sure we know this by, oh, I don't know, playing the worst Christmas music ever to exist through every speaker they could possibly find. This is how I imagine retail stores react literally the second it rolls over from October 31st to November 1st. Of course, we're talking about particularly horrible versions of Christmas songs. And the thing is here is it's not just pop music. There's plenty of great examples of pop versions of Christmas songs. It has nothing to do with this idea of, oh, it's modern Christmas music, it must be bad. It's just that there are some things out there that, I can't figure out why they exist. It's the kind of Christmas music that makes you think they're deliberately attempting to make our ears bleed so we'll get our shit and get out of the store faster, which actually might be somewhat useful this year. And here's the kicker of it too. Like, you've heard me kind of tear into music that I have not thought was particularly good before, but that's not exactly what's going on here, because as you'll see, there are some examples that I'm talking about where musically and as a song on its own, it's not bad, but I'm still left scratching my head going, why was this made? Why is this a Christmas song? What the hell does this have to do with Christmas? So anyways, I thought we would listen to a few different examples of this and kind of break them down a little bit and figure out what's going on and talk about what makes them maybe good or not so good musically, but then collectively scratch our heads as to why on earth somebody would decide turned into a Christmas song. So first things first, I want to check out a song by Mariah Carey, who is undoubtedly got one of the most incredible voices of all time. I mean, she's unbelievable. But I'm left listening to this kind of going, why? Okay, all right, let's just check out a little bit of this.
Give me some of that eggnog. Hey.
Give me some of that eggnog. I love it. It's amazing. And you know what? The groove here is pretty good. I actually dig it. See, and this is my problem with this stuff. It's fun, like, yeah, and I know I've said this, you guys have seen me say this so many times in videos, like, it's fine, there's nothing wrong with it. And I know I say it all the time, but like, it's because it's true. Musically, I have no problem with this. For me, where I'm left scratching my head is I'm just like, why? Why is it, you know, it could be summed up with two words. Secondhand embarrassment. I don't know. Don't get me wrong, this is all, you know, people have all types of different opinions. If you love this song, great. I don't know. I hear it and I'm just like, why did they do this? Bells are ringing, children singing, all is merry. And she's got this amazing voice that's just like, Mariah Carey's great. All right, so this is a medley. We're starting to combine tunes now. Let's just throw every Christmas song into this one thing. Sure. Woo! This, okay, look, all right, that's sick. That is great. That's amazing. What is that? Let's figure out what that is. All right, so we have. Okay, now what you might expect here, you'd probably expect it to sound like this. That would be kind of maybe a normal resolution to that, but instead, here's what they do. That sounds great, you know, and this is kind of what I'm saying. Like, there's nothing wrong necessarily with the music. It's just so strange to me why, like, this has become Christmas music. I get it doesn't even sound like Christmas music. Does it have sleigh bells?
Gather round, gather round.
Oh yeah, there's sleigh bells in there. Way in the back of the mix, there's sleigh bells. I guess that's the only thing that technically makes it Christmas, I guess? Because really nothing else sounds like Christmas, but there's just some, there's some bits and pieces in here that are great. And overall, I mean, the groove is kind of fun and like, and of course, like we said, Mariah Carey's voice is just incredible. So, but it's just so weird. Like, why? Why is this a, I don't get it. Here's another one by another person who is phenomenal in so many different things. And then there's this. This is Christina Aguilera. Clever play on words here. Xtina's Xmas, Christina's Christmas. Get it? Yeah. Sleigh bells. That's all you need. If you want to turn anything, literally anything at all, into a Christmas song, add some sleigh bells, you're good to go. Whisper Christmas time, and you got a Christmas song. She's so great. It's so confusing. It's so confusing to me. I don't know why. I think this is the entire song. That's the whole thing. Yeah, it's only like a minute and a half. Great groove. It's just, why is this a Christmas song? I have no idea. But, you know, Walmart, have at it, play it away. Oh, I see a few comments talking about using the song for like a dance class. That's a great application for it. Why is it a Christmas song? All right, next up, let's talk about Justin Bieber. obviously, Justin has been one of the most polarizing figures in music. But you know what? And I think a lot of people seem to be agreeing with this, like, dude's getting it together. You know, it's been a long time coming. I mean, and you can imagine being a kid in his position and how hard that's gotta be. So I gotta say, though, some of the stuff he's been putting out recently, I'm really, really legitimately impressed by. I know we made fun of Yummy there a while back. 50-50 love the way it's fit. But some of the stuff he's been doing recently, yeah, I actually enjoy quite a bit. This is from 9 years ago, and there's some fun stuff in here. Let's check this out. Honestly, at this point, okay, yeah. I mean, seems totally normal, seems totally fine. Just a cover of Drummer Boy with maybe a little bit of a modern twist. All right, here we go. This is where we have our twist. It's clever. It's clever. It's just like, it's just so okay. Oh, there's Busta Rhymes. Okay, here we go. Bieber, what up? Yes. This is okay. This is actually kind of cool. I mean, they kind of drop the beat down into like this halftime kind of backbeat thing, which is kind of neat. And like, and Busta Rhymes, yeah, it's just pretty cool. At the table with the family, having dinner, blackberry on a him, and then they gave a little flick, and then I took a look to see before it activates. The ringer came and realized the homie Bieber hit me on a Twitter, then I hit him back despite I had some food up on my finger, sipping eggnog with a little sprinkle of vanilla, even though it's kind of cold. I'm pulling out a chinchilla. Bieber hit me back and said, let's make it hot up in the winter. I said, cool. You know I'm a deliver, let's collaborate and make the holiday a little bigger. Before we work, I gotta get this off, see the other family members and drop gifts off, then I'm headed to the studio because ain't nothing stopping. How you know we about to turn it up and really get it popping now? People everywhere and all our Twitter followers, Merry Christmas, Kwanzaa, Happy Hanukkah. That's great. I don't know. That's why I'm so perplexed by modern pop-ish Christmas music. Is it's like, you can't even listen to it and be like, oh, this just sounds so bad. No, I just, because it's half the time it's not. I mean, there's a lot of really cool things that have happened in some of this stuff. I just find myself listening to it just kind of confused. Like, I guess this is Christmas music. I mean, the lyrics are kind of about Christmas, and there's sleigh bells. Sure, but it's just, I don't know, it's fascinating. And I always find myself walking around retail stores and malls and stuff like that, just listening to stuff that's on the radio, being like, who made this? Like, why was this? I'm just genuinely perplexed. But I mean, hey, you know, people probably love this stuff. I'm sure just as many people feel about this the way that I feel about Vince Guaraldi's Charlie Brown Christmas album. To each their own, but it's fascinating to me. But the one thing I think we can all agree on is November 1st is just too early for this shit.
Come on, everybody. Make sure you sing along. Here we go.
They're not all good. That's gonna do it for this week's video. It's been a lot of fun to dive into some of this music some of it's really great and extremely curious, and then others is also curious, but maybe not so great. And so there's just a ton of stuff to dive into. I really want to know, like, what is your favorite Christmas music? Let me know in the comments below. So as always, thank you so much for your time. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.